Hello everyone, I am Sikandar Hader and you are watching Electrical Tutorials channel. In this tutorial, you will learn about how to test inverter compressor winding using a multimeter. Here I have a inverter compressor, a VSD drive and a multimeter. In this video, you will also learn how to run this compressor directly without a VSD drive. Is this compressor work without VSD drive or not? In normal single pass or three pass compressor, we don't have the permanent magnet, but in inverter compressor, we have a permanent magnet and the winding is for three pass. The output terminals is for UVW. In normal single pass compressor, we have two types of winding, main winding and auxiliary winding. The connection between main and auxiliary winding is called common. The other side of main winding is called run and the other side of auxiliary winding is called start. But in inverter compressor, the output terminal is for UVW because the internal winding is for three pass. We provide 220 volts to this inverter circuit and this inverter circuit first convert the AC supply to the DC, and after the DC the supply is converted to the three pass using IGBTs. Further, we will make videos about this type of VSD circuit and how it's working, the testing and the repairing videos, and how to test a VSD drive using a multimeter and compressor. But before to explain how to test the inverter compressor winding using a multimeter, first of all we need to learn about the single pass compressor, and after that we will talk about the three pass inverter compressor or BLDC type inverter compressor. The diagram is the best way to explain something easily. So here I have a single pass motor winding diagram or capacitor start winding diagram. First of all, look at the diagram. In the diagram we have two types of winding. One is called main winding and the other one is called auxiliary winding. You can see that the connection between main and auxiliary winding is called common, and the other side is for run, and the capacitor is connected between the auxiliary and the run winding. So this diagram is for the single pass capacitor run motor or capacitor start motor. Here I have two diagrams of three pass motor winding. One is star connection and the another one is delta connection. First look at two star connection. The one and two coil is connected between one another, and the one and three coil is also connected with one another. Just like this, the 2 and 3 is connected with one another, and the 2 is 1 is also connected with one another. So if the resistance between 1 and 2 is 5 ohm, then the resistance between 1 and 3 will be also 5 ohm, and the resistance between 2 and 3 point will be also 5 ohm. If the resistance same, it means that the winding condition is good. If the resistance not same, it means that the internal winding is damaged or burned. Now look at two delta diagram. If the resistance between 1 and 2 is 10 ohm, so the resistance between 1 and 3 will be also 10 ohm, and the resistance between 2 and 3 will be also 10 ohm. If the resistance not same, it means that the internal winding is in damaged condition. So come to the practical video. Here I have three terminals for three pass supply UVW. So to test this compressor winding, first of all we need to set the multimeter on ohm testing. In the video I am using digital multimeter. You can also test the winding using analog multimeter. You can also test the winding using connectivity option, but I suggest to use ohm testing option. If I test terminal 1 with terminal 2, the resistance is 9.6 or 9.4 ohm. So if I test the resistance between another terminal, the resistance is 9.5 or 9.4 ohm, which is same. If I test with another one, the resistance is also same. It means that the internal winding is in a good condition and we can run this compressor with compatible VSD drive circuit. Now, can we run this inverter compressor directly without a VSD drive? So the simple answer is no, because this compressor works on 3-pass, and if we provide 3-pass supply and voltage according the compressor winding, so the compressor will run, but at the speed will be too slow, because our supply is only 50 or 60 hertz and this compressor required 150 hertz to complete the full speed. I hope you got some knowledge from this video. If you want this type of videos, please subscribe our YouTube channel and don't forget to like and share this video. Bye bye.